Welcome to the master's talk, and this master's talk I am going to discuss about the binary logic. What is binary logic? Binary logic is based on the type of a statement one particular set of person can make, and based on that we have to check the consistency of set of a statement. That is basic premises, or basic you can say goal of this binary logic. Means set of a statement spoken by set of people, and that all the statement we have to check the consistency. All are truth, all are correct, all are wrong. Means consistency. If one we have assumed correct, then all should be correct accordingly. If one we have assumed this is wrong, then all should be consistent accordingly. Means consistency of a statement we will check based on the binary logic. This is your part of non-RCA section or verbal reasoning, or of course it is a part of your verbal ability, logic and synthesis of a statement. Again, synthesis of a statement is a very big part of your logic and philosophy. How to synthesize the statement? This is, you can say, complete scientific and mathematical process, synthesis of a statement. Here a lot of role will be there, like your vocab, and afterwards preposition, or you can say grammar, lot of role will be there. How to synthesize the statement, like how we are synthesizing the equation, like quadratic equation, cubic equation, we will totally break down at the zero level. Dum tod tod ke usko samajh jate hain, say ye. Same base, synthesis of a statement is a just mathematical and grammatical process, or you can say overview, it is a logical process to understand the statement in correct way. And that is the role of philosopher. They will be able to synthesize the statement in different way based on the logic. Then again, logic will not leave you always. All verbal reasoning part, logic will be one of the central idea. Based on that only all the verbal reasoning has developed. Then binary logic is based on the three types of person who states about himself, herself and others. Like any person is there, he will tell something about himself, or if gender is you can say ladies, then they will tell about herself, or you can say himself or herself, or other statement we will make about the others, means other people. There's only two type of things we will able to make: what I am, what others are. What I am, what you are. What you are, what others are there. Then based on that person statement, three type of person can be. Three type of person can be. For this logic I am telling, I am not categorizing the person biologically or socially grown, or they are from different region or religion. I am not categorizing. I am just categorizing based on the making the statements about himself, herself or about the others. Only this segment, only this particular criteria I am just picking here. Based on the statement about himself, herself and others, three type of person will be there. One is truth teller, that is shortcut we will tell TT. One is liar and another is alternator. Then shortcut we can say TT means truth teller, liar means L, alternator means AL. What all these three type of person? Name itself is very clear, but again we will try to understand little very refined way, means confusion should be not there. Truth teller, a person whom each and every statement is true, means not a single statement is false. Each and every statement, if it is true, either about himself or herself or maybe about others, all a statement will be true, then it is. Those type of person will called truth teller. Second type of person is liar, a person whom each and every statement is false, then you can say it is a liar. Name itself clear, no issue. Alternator, little bit you have to careful. This only will make you confusion. A person whom statements are alternately true and false, or vice versa. Alternate means one statement, if it is true, next statement will be false. The next statement again it will be true, next statement will be false. If you have taken any of the three statements, then order may be, first statement if it is true, then second will be false, third will be true. Or order may be false, true, false. But any of the order, alternate statement always will be different. Different means one will be true, next will be false. Then next again will be true, next again will be false. Or if it is a starting from false, then first statement false, again next will be true, again next will be false. This pattern will be keep on maintained. Now question, which type of question will come? Because once we will not discuss about the questions, you will not able to understand. Generally questions will be based on the logic of consistency. Consistency of the given set of statements spoken by a set of persons. Usually in a set of person will be two or three. In question, only set of statements made by the person will be given. In question, Generally, only set of a statement will be given. It will not disclose which person is truth teller or liar or alternator. This is only beauty of this type of question. It will not decide like Ram, Mohan or Sam, three person are there. They made some statement or fewer statements. Then it will not given Ram is truth teller or Sam is liar or maybe Mohan is alternator. It will not given. You have to assume if Ram is truth teller, then Ram's statement will be correct. If Ram's statement is correct, then accordingly Sam's statement and other person's statement, it should be consistent. It should not contradict to each other. Like one statement, if it is telling Sam is a liar, then other statement, it should not be a valid point. Sam is not a liar. If Sam is a liar, then from every of the person, it should be proven. It should be consistent. Sam is a liar. Okay, that means consistency check. Then only set of a statement made by person will be given. About the person means they are truth teller, liar or alternator will be not given. One point. Another point, about the statement also will be not given, which is true, which is false. You have to assume. You have to just check. Just assume. Just suppose this statement is true. Now, based on the truthness of this statement, all other statements should be consistent. If it is not consistent, your assumption was wrong. Means you have to assume that a statement not true, that a statement was false. If you will start to consider that a statement was false, then other statement will keep on come inconsistency. That is only because a statement can be only two type, either true or false. Then what do we have to do? We have to do by heat and trial, common sense and observation, we have to check and verify that all the statements are consistent and it is not contradicting to each other. Based on that, it will be decided who are truth teller, who are liar, who are alternator. But generally question will be there. You have to decide out of that person, out of given person, who are the truth teller, who are the liar and who are the alternator. That will be good. Means in question about the statement, nature of a statement not given. What not given, you just listen properly. Just listen properly. That only going to make a major role to solve this question. About the statement not given. It is true, false, whatever. First thing. Second thing about the person, it is not given. He is the truth teller, liar or alternator. Second thing. Third thing, afterwards also it will not given like which statement will be consistent, which will not consistent. Which you have to consider first, which we have to consider second. Nothing will be given. All you have to assume, but your assumption should be correct. If your assumption is not correct, then you have to assume some other thing. That means only we have to think. And afterwards, little bit practice and little keyword you have to just catch. Then whatever you have to assume, that also will be decided. That again, little bit common sense and shortcut. Just we'll take one example. Three characters of film Sholay, Jai, Viru and Thakur. They are talking to each other. Jai is telling, I am not the liar. Thakur is liar. I don't know what will happen. He will continue his job or Thakur will kill him. We don't know. Just here a statement is there. I am not the liar. Thakur is liar. Viru is telling, I am not the liar. Jai is the truth teller. Thakur is telling, I am not alternator. Viru is liar. How to resolve? Who is telling correct? Who is a truth teller? Who is a liar and who is alternator? How to resolve the conflict among these three people? Somebody will be truth teller and somebody will be alternator and somebody will be your liar. But how to decide? Because in question, it will not given which a statement is true, which a statement is false. Nothing is given. In question, it will also not given Jai is truth teller or Viru is truth teller or Thakur always speak liar. That also will not given. Means we don't know about the person. Ye jhoota hai, sachcha hai, ya badal ke bolne wala hai, ya we don't know any of the statement, it is true or false. Then how to resolve the conflict? How to resolve the conflict? But heat and trial, we have to start some point. Any of the person, any first statement, we have to just take assumption, it is true. That is one of the way, heat and trial way. Like Jai, first will take first statement, I am not the liar, Thakur is liar. First thing you just tell me, here only observation is coming in picture. If your observation is good, if you have little bit verbal reasoning or you are a good reader or you are a good observer, this line will make you some awareness how to make the assumption. Assumption you have to make, there is no issue. But by heat and trial, like here six statement is there. Then six assumption you can make. Any of the statement can be of true or false. six statement, all the six statement can be true or false, then how many option you have? 12 option you have. 6 into 2, 12 options are there, means 12 hit and trial options you have. If you will start to do all 12 hit and trial option, solving one question, how much time it will take? It will take more than 3 to 4 minutes. Is it worth to solve in your CAT exam? If you are solving one question after 3 minutes, is it worth? No, leave the question. Either you can leave the question if you are not able to solve, or otherwise you just sharpen your observation based on the one or two observation. This 12 hit and trial method you will able to reduce in hardly 1 or 2. Then 1 or 2 assumption you can do, there is not a issue, and you will able to arrive the conclusion within 1 minute, 40 second or 50 second or maybe 1 minute. Or once you arrive the conclusion, maybe one set of information, two question will be there, then 1 minute or 1.5 minute, if you are able to solve 2 question, you are gaining the time, you are not losing the time. Then here I will focus this statement, I am not a liar. Can this statement be made by any of the liar or any of the truth teller? Is it possible? Or second statement, just here come, Viru is making, I am the liar. This statement truth teller can make. If he is a truth teller, how he can say I am a liar? He cannot say. It is a contradiction. If he is a truth teller, he cannot say he is a liar. If he is a liar, can he say I am a liar? Just try to think. These are simple common sense. Just I will analyze. No need to worry. Here comes. Viru, I am the liar. Just think, if Viru is a liar, then he cannot say truth that I am a liar. If he is a liar, if he is telling I am a liar, then this is become a true statement. If he is making the true statement, then how he will become a liar? Then how you can say I am a liar? I think it is puzzling you. No need to worry. It is not a puzzling. It is just a matter of understanding from RHS to LHS and LHS to RHS. Viru is telling I am a liar. If Viru is a liar, then he cannot say truth. Means this statement cannot be true. If this statement is true, I am a liar, means Viru is a truth teller. If Viru is a truth teller, then how you can say I am a liar? Where is the conflict? Conflict is Viru cannot be truth teller, Viru cannot be liar. Both is contradicting. Then only option is there, Viru can be alternator. That is only solution. That is only compromise. Because if you are considered Viru is a truth teller, that is also conflict. If you are considered Viru is a liar, that is also conflict. Then which is the best compromising situation? Alternator. One statement is telling lie, another is telling correct. Means one he will tell false, another he will make true. Correct. That is only one he will make true, one he will make lie. One statement he will make true, one statement he will make lie. Alternate. Now, if Viru is alternator, then two option is there. He is making two statement, false or true, or true or false. Means first statement can be false, and then second statement is true. This is your first statement, this is your second statement. What is second statement made by Viru? Second statement is Jay is the truth teller. Okay, now just we'll try to correlate with Jay's statement. If he is alternated, if it is a false and true, then Viru is a false and true, then what will happen? Jay is a truth teller. If Jay is a truth teller, second statement is correct, first statement is false. If Jay is a truth teller, then just will match Jay's statement. Why Jay is telling? I am not the liar. What is the meaning? Not liar. Not liar means just opposite of that. I am not a liar means I am a truth teller. He is telling correct. If he is a truth teller and he is telling I am a truth teller, then he is 100% consistent. If I am speaking truth and I am telling I am a truth teller, it is consistent. But if I am a liar, I am telling I am the liar, then it is not consistent. You cannot say, one liar person cannot say I am a liar. But one truth teller person can say I am a truth teller. Then Jay is a truth teller. That is Jay's statement, and Viru's statement also, second statement is, this is Jay is a truth teller. Then this only option is there, false and true. Then Viru first statement is false, second statement is true. Means based on that we can say Jay is truth teller. Then Jay is I am not the liar, Jay is a truth teller. And Thakur is liar. If Jay is truth teller, means Jay, both of the statement will be correct. Second statement is Thakur is liar. If Thakur is liar, that will be truth, because Jay is truth teller. Now it is totally decided. Jay is truth teller and Thakur is liar because Jay is telling. Jay is telling Thakur is liar and Jay is a truth teller. Then Jay cannot say wrong. Jay cannot say wrong due to Thakur is liar. And bach gaya Biru. Biru is alternator. Very clear. Job is done. Job is done. You have decided. Now just we'll recheck. Just will don't in between you decide. Maybe some other possibility will be there. Just will check the Thakur statement also. Thakur is a liar as per Jay means both her statements should be false. Statement one, I am the alternator. That is false. Thakur is a liar. He is telling I am alternate. Second statement, Viru is the liar. That is also false. Viru is alternator. Then both her statement is false means Thakur is a liar. Then Jay, he is a truth teller. A statement one also true. A statement two also true. Viru is an alternator. A statement one is false. A statement second is true. Thakur is a liar. A statement one also false. A statement two also false. Very clear. Over. Based on this information, maybe two questions will be given. You will be able to understand. Then this is a concept of binary logic. Here set of a statement made by set of people, and we have to decide which statement is true, which statement is false, and which person is truth teller, which person is liar or alternator without any information. Means about the statement, about the person, no information will be given in question. Only based on the assumption and little bit observation and common sense, you have to make some assumption and you have to check the consistency of all the statement. Then continue to learn at the rate of www.paruliko.com. Thank you.